Hi friends, welcome to my channel. My channel name is Chemistry Coaching for MCET, MSc, CSAR, UGC NET. Here I am providing videos for intermediate students, BSc students, MSc students, PhD students. Please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon and give me a like. In this video, I am going to discuss about pericyclic reactions, particularly about electrocyclic reactions. So this video is very helpful to MSc students. Let's get into the video. So today topic is pericyclic reactions. In pericyclic reactions, I am going to discuss about electrocyclic reactions. So here the characteristics of pericyclic reactions. Pericyclic reactions means these reactions are moving through cyclic transition state. So that's why we are calling the reactions are pericyclic reactions. So pericyclic reactions are kinetically controlled reactions. So kinetically controlled means, so the rate is depends on the energy of transition state. So kinetically controlled means if the rate is depends on the transition state energy. Proceeds with a decrease in entropy. Change in delta G is negligible. Induced by heat or light. This is very important. This pericyclic reactions are induced by heat or light. So thermal pericyclic reactions are E0 level reactions. Photochemical reactions are E1 level reactions. So reactions proceeds with the cyclic transition state. These reactions are concerted reactions. Concerted means single step, no intermediate. So therefore, these reactions are moving in concerted manner through via cyclic transition state. No formation of ionic, radical, neutral intermediates. No radical, no cationic, no anionic intermediates. The rate of the reaction is usually unaffected by the catalyst and nature of the solvents. So the reactions are products are very highly stereospecific. So here pericyclic reactions are five types. So first one is electrocyclic reaction. Second one is cycloaddition reactions. Third one is sigmatropic reactions. Fourth one is kilotropic reactions. Fifth one is group transfer reactions. So present today I am going to discuss about electrocyclic reactions. So electrocyclic reaction means the substrate has to follow these conditions. So the condition number one, molecule should be with the continuous pi conjugation. So first you have to observe the molecule. You have to see like a continuous conjugation is there or not. So here the two double bonds are in conjugation. So conjugation means continuous conjugation is there. So if you, then the second condition is the termini of pi conjugation should be spatially closer. So this carbon and this carbon are spatially close. Spatially close means then the reaction will proceed. Spatially far away, the reaction is going to go very difficult. So these two carbons 1, 4 are spatially close. So formation of product should not lead to severe steric crowding. Why? Because if you have polyene also or conjugated diene also, if your product is steric, having steric strain, the reaction will not possible. And another condition is pi conjugation may be acyclic or cyclic. Pi conjugation may be cyclic or acyclic. So the both molecules will participate in the reaction. So here what will happen is formation of a new sigma bond is generating. Suppose the formation of new sigma bond at the termini of conjugation pi system means its reverse process is called electrocyclization. So what is happening is in the electrocyclic electrocyclization, there is a sigma bond between 1 and 4th carbon. and one fourth carbon. In the reverse process, the sigma bond is broken, another pi bond is generated. So here in the electrocyclization, one pi bond is broken and you are generating a sigma bond. So here see your expense of one pi bond, you are getting a sigma bond. You are getting one sigma bond here. So another thing is in the electrocyclization, you have to calculate the number of pi bonds. Suppose if you, in this molecule there is a pi bonds, means 3 pi bonds, 1, 2, 3. 3 pi bonds is odd number of pi bonds. Odd number of pi bonds means the system is 4n plus 2 pi system. So in this system you have to calculate the number of pi bonds, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pi bonds, even number of pi bonds. Even number of pi bonds means 4n pi electron system. So 4n pi electron system. Other way you have to calculate the electrons also, 4n pi. It is having 4 pi electrons or 8 pi electrons, 12 pi electrons. It is said to be 4n pi electron system. Or it is having 2 pi electrons, 6 pi electrons, 10 pi electrons. Then it is said to be 4n plus 2 system. So in electrocyclization, first you have to decide it is 4n pi or 4n plus 2. So here stereochemical course in the electrocyclic reaction. So first what you have to do, you have to take the diene compound, diene. So first in electrocyclation there is two mode of electrocyclation, con mode of electrocyclation, dis mode of electrocyclation. So in con mode electrocyclation, you have to rotate the groups, both groups in the same direction clockwise. You see here we are rotating clockwise. So here also we are rotating clockwise. So you are rotating clockwise means, so you are getting clockwise rotation. This is called, if you do the rotation clock both group, both sides, both terminates at both sides, you do clockwise rotation, it is con mode. So con mode of electrocyclic. In other way you can do the both anti-clockwise rotation at both termini. So both termini, then it is said to be con electrocyclization. In another way, for diselectrocyclization, one side you are doing clockwise rotation, another side anti-clockwise rotation. So this is called dis mode of electrocyclization. Other way you can do one side anti-clockwise rotation, another side clockwise rotation. Then we can call it as dis mode of electrocyclization. So this is very important. So after this, you know now con mode of electrocyclation, dis mode of electrocyclation. First what we have to do, first you have to select the groups at the termini. So first I am selecting this group A. So you see A, the direction A is in this way. So A is, suppose A is left side, B is right side. So A is left side, B is right side. Here also A is left side, B is right side. So A and A both are in same side. So in the electrocyclization, what will happen, con mode of electrocyclization, if both groups are same direction, so product also they will get on same plane. So both groups are same side means in the product also you are getting same side. This is very important. So first you have to select the groups and you see whether the both groups are same side or opposite side. So both groups are same side means then in the product also you will get same side, or either both groups are in opposite side, in the products you will get opposite side. This is the rules for con electrocyclization. For in the diselectrocyclization, what will happen is if you have to choose the both groups are same side. Here A and A are both are same side. So in the both are same side, if you do diselectrocyclization, both groups will get opposite side. Opposite side means different plane. So A is up above the plane, B is the below the plane. This is very important. So if at the terminal selected groups are opposite direction, you will get the same direction in the product. Same direction means, so you will get the same direction means above or below the plane. So these rules are very important to decide the product. So these rules are very crucial. You have to memorize or you have to learn these rules, and these rules will apply into how to do con mode of electrocyclization, dis mode of electrocyclization. Okay, then we will come to the example one. So in example one, first we are doing here con electrocyclization. So first of all, what will they will in the questions, what will they will give symbol, thermal or photochemical. So according to the selection rules, first thermal for 4n pi system, con electrocyclization is allowed for thermal condition. So they are giving symbol like thermal symbol, you have to do like conductor cyclization. So if they are given for the H nu condition, you have to do this electrocyclization. So first here you have to select the groups. Selected this, this see here. Here both groups are at opposite side. So both groups are both methyls are opposite side, or both hydrogens are opposite side. So here what you are doing is you are doing con electrocyclization. So con electrocyclization means both groups are at opposite side. In the pyrite also you are getting both groups opposite side. So here you are getting two pyrites as a racemic mixture. So if you do this electrocyclization, both groups are at opposite side. So opposite side in the this electrocyclization, both will group come at same side. This is very important. This is in the this electrocyclization. So here example 2, in the same in the like example 1, here also both groups are at opposite side, methyl and methyl, both groups are opposite side. Opposite side means in calm electrocyclization, both groups are opposite side means you will get both groups at opposite side. So this is the product. So in this product both two products are possible. You will get a racemic mixture. If you do this electrocyclization, both groups are opposite side. So the product you will get both groups at same side. So this is happening in the this electrocyclization. If you come to example 3, you have to, here we are doing electrocyclic ring opening. In the electrocyclic ring opening, you have to see how the methyls are. So in the methyls, both groups are one group, one methyl is up, one group of methyl are down. So means both groups are at opposite side. So you are doing con rotation. What will happen? Opposite groups will come opposite side. So opposite side means here you are getting opposite sides. Both, you see in this product, both methyl, this methyl and this methyl, both are at opposite side. This is also one product, but in this product also both methyls are opposite. But here there is a steric hindrance between these two methyls. So this is forming very low percent. It is forming major product. So if you do this electrocyclization, what will happen is both groups are at opposite side in this electrocyclization. So both opposite groups will come same side in this electrocyclization. Therefore, two products are forming. So we are coming to example 4. This is also electrocyclic ring opening. So if you are getting a product, first you have to observe how the groups are there. So one group is up the middle, one group is middle, means opposite faces. Opposite means you are doing con electrocyclization. So in con electrocyclization, you are getting both groups at opposite side. So two products are possible. One is your minor product. Why? Because already we discussed in the previous slide, these two methyls are here, there is having steric hindrance. Because of the steric hindrance, this product is minor product and this is the major product. So if you come to this electrocyclization, you have to see both groups are opposite side. Opposite side means in this electrocyclization, you will get both methyls at same side. So here you are getting both methyls at same side. So you are getting two products. So here we are coming to 8 pi electron system, you have to observe these methyl groups. So both methyl groups are at opposite side. So opposite side means we are doing con electrocyclization. Con electrocyclization means opposite groups come in opposite direction. Opposite direction means you are getting two products. These two products will come as a racemic mixture. So if we come to this electrocyclization, so both methyls are opposite groups. So in this electrocyclization, opposite groups will come same direction. Same direction means you are getting both group methyl groups above the plane. So now we are coming to 2 pi electron system. 2 pi electron system means we are doing here both con and this electrocyclization. So by here we have to observe same like in the previous slides. So both methyl groups are opposite side. So opposite side means what you are doing? You are doing con electrocyclization. So con electrocyclization means you are getting both methyl groups at opposite side. So here if you do this electrocyclization, so both methyls are opposite. In the this electrocyclization, opposite group will come same side. So this is it's a 2 pi electron system. if we come to this this system, so you have to observe here. So here is two hydrogens are opposite side. Two hydrogens are opposite side means you are subjecting Carnot electrocyclic. So Carnot electrocyclic, opposite hydrogens are coming opposite side. So you are getting this product. So if you subject this electrocyclization, opposite groups will come same side. So you may get this product or this product. So this is the another example. So in this example, you have to see whether these groups are, these hydrogens are opposite or same side. So this is cyclopentadienyl type. So here you have to observe both methyls are opposite side. Both methyls are opposite side means in the Carnot electrocyclization, you are getting both methyls at opposite side. So in the diselectrocyclization, both methyls are opposite. So in the diselectrocyclization, you are getting both methyls at same side. So if we come to example 9, you see the structure, these two hydrogens are opposite. So you are in the two hydrogens are opposite, you are subjected into Carnot electrocyclization. So Carnot electrocyclization, the opposite groups are coming opposite side. So you see the product here. If you subject this same stratimetal with diselectrocyclization, the both hydrogens are opposite side is coming to same side in the product. If you subjected to diselectrocyclization. Next, coming to example 10. So you see the structure here, these two hydrogens are opposite, or you can see, you can select both R groups, both methylene groups, both methylene groups are opposite. So opposite means are both hydrogens are opposite, you are subjected to Carnot electrocyclization. So Carnot electrocyclization means opposite hydrogens are coming here in the product as opposite hydrogens are coming in the opposite direction. So if you subjected the same starting material with diselectrocyclization, so these two hydrogens are coming same side. So opposite hydrogens are coming same side in the diselectrocyclization. Okay, then coming to example 11. So here methylenes are replaced by methane, so CH. So hydrogens are opposite side. So hydrogens are opposite side means we are subjecting here Carnot electrocyclization. So Carnot electrocyclization means opposite hydrogens are coming opposite in the product. So if you subject the same starting metal with diselectrocyclization, the opposite hydrogens are coming same side in the product. So we are coming to example 12. So here big ring is there. So you have to see, this is a 6 pi electron system left hand side, and right hand side 6 pi electron system. So here both hydrogens are opposite. So in the product, both hydrogens are coming opposite direction. In the another ring also, both hydrogens are coming opposite direction. So if you subject them same starting material with diselectrocyclization, what is happening is both hydrogens are opposite. So both hydrogens are coming same side in the product. So first ring and second ring, both hydrogens are coming same side in the product. So if you come to example 13, first you have to observe the hydrogens. So the hydrogens are, both hydrogens are above the plane. Both hydrogens are above the plane means same side. Same side means you have to subject to diselectrocyclization here. Same side means you have to get opposite sides in the product. So you are getting both hydrogens opposite. You have to observe these hydrogens too. So these hydrogens are opposite. So here this is the electrocyclic ring opening. If you subjected to Carnot electrocyclization, both hydrogens are same side. So you are getting both hydrogens at same side. So here we are doing one more time electrocyclic ring opening. So here both hydrogens are opposite. So if you are subjected to Carnot electrocyclization, so both hydrogens are opposite side. So opposite you are getting. If you subjected this starting material to diselectrocyclization, what will happen is this opposite hydrogens are coming same side. So if you subject to this diselectrocyclization, the both hydrogens will come same side. So this is a very important example. These examples, these problems are appeared in CSR exam. So we are discussing here the problem. The problem they will ask, how we will convert this compound to this product. So how you will convert this product to this product. So you have to do first con followed by next con. How we will see. So here first these two phenyls are opposite. So if you subject to con mode electrocyclation, what will happen is these two phenyls will come opposite. So this is ring closure. If you are doing one more time ring opening, what is happening is these two phenyls are opposite. So we are getting these two phenyls are opposite in the electrocyclic ring opening. This is a simple way to convert the one product to another product. So another example here. So here one is trans, in two methyls are trans. So how you will convert these two trans methyls to cis? That is the question. So what you are doing is, first you are doing con electrocyclation, both methyls are opposite. So in the product you are getting both methyls opposite. So one more time you are doing this electrocyclic ring closure. So ring closure means both methyls are opposite side. In the this ring closure, you will get both methyls are at same side. So this is very important. So if we come to example number 17, same problem like previous slide. How you convert cis ring junction to trans? So first you are doing here this electrocyclic ring opening. So one, what is happening? Two methyls are same side. So if you convert this, so in the this electrocyclic ring opening, the two methyls will come opposite side. So opposite side. Once you the opposite hydrogens are subjected to con electrocyclation, electrocyclic ring closure, the two hydrogens, the two hydrogens will come opposite side. So this is the ring, you are doing ring closure here. So here you have to observe the hydrogen stereochemistry. So what will happen is, in the problems they will give, suppose they will provide one 4N5 system, and they will give symbols like thermal or photochemical. So if they are giving four N5 system, thermal means you have to do con electrocyclation. If they are giving, they are providing 4N5 system, and they are mentioning there is a HNU condition or photochemical condition, you have to dis electrocyclation. So you have to memorize. I memorize it like this is CT. CT means for 4N5 system, con thermal. So for con thermal like CT scan. So in CT scan, CT means con thermal. So you have to memorize 4N5. The remaining 4N system. So it is opposite to 4N+2 system. So for 4N system, they are giving con. You have to do. They are providing thermal condition. You have to do conodation. Finally, thank you. If you have any doubts regarding, please comment in the video. And I am providing useful books for who is pursuing MSc and who are preparing for CSR UGC. The useful books are in the description. Please click on the link in the description. Thank you.